Support WrestleTalk!
Give us a subscribe. Hello and welcome to the WrestleTalk news. I'm Ollie Davis. Following the apparent start of Randy Orton and Rusev's SummerSlam feud on this week's SmackDown, two men who've recently been involved in a series of over-the-top gimmick matches, comedy account WWE Creative Humor tweeted, "I'll fight you, just no Punjabi prison matches or House of Horrors or flag matches or any other bullshit matches. Randy Orton, SmackDown Live." You know who agrees with that joke? That maybe Randy Orton has been booked in some ridiculous stipulations over the last few months? Randy Orton himself. The Viper retweeted the gag from out of nowhere this week, and he's now struck again, reposting another creative humor tweet. So this is pretty funny. "Get the new Brock Lesnar, eat, sleep, threaten to leave for UFC when your contract is up to get more money, repeat shirt, hashtag merch." If Brock Lesnar is on the way out of WWE, he might be hot tagging in the currently out with injury Paige, who's claimed she's nearing an in-ring return. "I just had my CT scan today, and I do my last checkup on Monday with my good friend and doctor, Dr. Arribe, in Arizona. Hopefully I'll be back sooner rather than later, but I don't know at this point. I don't know where it is, but I can't wait to get back to work. I'm excited to get back to WWE." Her comments came in an interview with Bully Ray on Busted Open Radio, which Paige and her fiancé Alberto El Patron, the former Alberto Del Rio in WWE, requested to set the record straight over their recent airport altercation. TMZ initially reported that Alberto was arguing with a woman and police were called when things escalated last month. The Orlando Police Department initially said they were investigating Del Rio for domestic violence battery, leading to GFW, the new name for TNA, suspending him, their world champion. But the police later also found that probable cause exists to charge Saraya Bevis, Paige, with battery domestic violence. Alberto and Paige explained that they're just passionate people who shouldn't, but sometimes do, argue in public. And this particular incident was greatly exaggerated by the media. Alberto had said something mean to Paige, so she poured a drink over his head. This caused Alberto to react angrily, and the police told them to go their separate ways until they'd both calmed down. Bully Ray brought up the claims made by Paige's brother, with Zach Bevis posting on Facebook, "She's with a control freak who think he's a tough guy because he beats my sister and has money to cover his tracks." The couple dismissed this as her family reacting into what they read online, which she claims is far from the actual truth. Alberto is now totally free and cleared from the investigation, but he remains suspended by GFW. Alberto said he gets to go back to work soon, but he won't be at the promotion's first live event dates in over a year this weekend. After WWE's recent run of cost-cutting, including dropping Pyro from their shows, cancelling a number of WWE Network programs, and delaying the weekly UK Championship show, it was feared talent releases would be next. And according to Wrestling Inc., that appears to have begun. The site reports Cruiserweight Classic competitor Ho-Ho Lun has been released by WWE. Lun joined NXT last year, with WWE hoping to create a Chinese star. He defeated Araya Davari in the Cruiserweight Classic's first round, but lost in the second to Noam Dar. He's infrequently appeared on NXT since, last seen losing to the Velveteen Dream on the 23rd of June. But why is WWE cutting costs backstage? And who is pushing for Samoa Joe to win the title at SummerSlam? Find out by clicking the videos on the left, press subscribe, and support WrestleTalk on Patreon. I've been Ollie Davis, and that was Wrestling.